Yeah, so I did start my career as an assistant director actually in advertising to Kunal Kapoor, who was Shashi Kapoor's son. And well, it happened quite by accident, so I wasn't even sure I wanted to do advertising. But he offered me a job, I took it up. And while I was working with him, people would see me on the set and somebody would call me for a film, somebody would call me for an ad film. And that's how it started. So I always say I'm an actor by accident. I accidentally started, you know, doing work as a model. I accidentally came into the film industry. And the rest, as they say, is destiny. So I'm glad that my destiny brought me here today. Yes, of course. Actually, quite honestly, like I said, I started my career as an assistant director. So I always wanted to be a director. I never wanted to be an actor. I never even thought about being an actor. Yes, of course, I used to like modeling, and you know, I used to get a lot of good offers in terms of being a model. At that time, there not many people like me. I was very raw, but I got some of the best, biggest campaigns at that time. I never really thought about becoming an actor. You know, you have to study, you have to train, and I had none of those. And I got Swabhiman, which became the biggest hit. But instead of saying that direction was a you know, extension of myself as an actor, I'd say direction is my true calling, really. Yes, I know I've carved a niche for myself as an actor in this industry, but if given a chance, I'd definitely want to make my own film or an OTT show or anything, but I'm happiest behind camera. You've really gone back and done your homework. Well, Shabana Azmi is somebody I have wanted to work with from the beginning of my career. Nasiruddin Shah, one of the thespians, one of the greatest actors according to me, not only in India but across the globe. I was very lucky that in my first film, my producer, who's also my friend Sanjay Gupta, he asked me, whom do I want? And I said, I want Shabana Azmi and Nasiruddin Shah. And he said, bhaiya, you know, please, itna bhi mat pucho. But I said, look, this is the, you know, my characters will be justified if I have these two actors. And they had not worked together for 19 years before they did my film. And it was a dream working with Shabana Ji and Naseer Bhai. They're so easy to work with. People say, you know, oh God, Shabana Azmi, Nasiruddin Shah, you must have had a tough time. No, I would have had a tough time if I had not worked with these actors. They've spoiled me for life. The commitment, the homework, the passion, the hunger, it's unbelievable. And Shabana Ji, I will never forget, she came, it was a 5 o'clock shift in the morning, 5 o'clock, 5 a.m. shift. She walked in like Shabana Azmi, went into her van, and in 45 minutes walked out looking like the character. And Naseer Bhai, oh, he's just, what do I say, effortless at everything he does. They're so different, both these actors. Shabana Ji does a lot of homework, she does a lot of layering to her characters. She does a lot, there's so much homework before she comes on the set. While Naseer Bhai just comes on the set, reads the lines and enacts in a very, which looks like an effortless process, but it's not, I'm sure. So yes, to sum up, I was very, very lucky to get both of them in my first film. As a child, I was crawling and I used to always go towards a bottle of Coca-Cola. And, you know, one of my neighbors, he said, ye hamesha bachcha Coca-Cola ki bottle dekhta hai, to uske taraf jata hai, iska naam Coco rakh do. That's how I got my nickname, Coco. Good question. I don't know. I don't know whether it helped me creatively refresh myself, but it made me hungrier. It made me also respect what I had. You know, sometimes you take a lot of things for granted. You take your success, you take your money, you take your house, you take your family, you take your food. You take a lot of things for granted because you're getting it easily. The lockdown, the pandemic, just taught us a lot of things of how to be in gratitude really for the things that you have earned or God has given you. And that's what I learned. I mean, every waking moment I'm thankful for the things I have, whether it's my family's health, whether it's my wealth, whether it's my family and friends, because they are the ones who actually tided us over during these tough, trying times. Did it refresh me as an actor? Maybe it did organically because I was hungry for more. But I don't think it really, I don't know, I can't put a finger on it. But if there has been a change, it's probably very, very subtle and internal. Externally, I can't feel it. What I enjoy the most, like I said, is direction. I enjoy directing the most because you end up being involved before the process of shooting happens and you only exit once everything is done, signed and sealed. So for me, the process of writing, the process of visualization, planning the film, shooting the film or the OTT or the television show, whatever I'm doing, and editing, I love editing. You know, I don't know, I might have been an editor in my previous life because I enjoy editing the most. I shoot my films, I've done a lot of television movies and some television work in the past, and I used to shoot it like an editor. A lot of people used to say, "Arey, yahan pe cut kiya, agla shot kahan se lega?" And being an actor helps you because you know what your next continuity is going to be. So if you ask me what I enjoy doing the most, I enjoy directing myself as an actor. Thank you very much for asking me all these questions. I'm refreshed now. Thank you and all the very best.